بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله رب العالمين All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be he glorified and exalted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us to enter into one of the best seasons or to be on the verge of entering into one of the best seasons of the year, the winter. The winter is a special time for the believer. It's related from our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الشتاء ربيع المؤمن طال ليله فقام وقصر نهاره فصام The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is related as saying a hadith related by in various versions by Imam Ahmad, Imam al-Bayhaqi and others on the authority of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he mentioned the winter is the springtime of the believer ash-shita'u rabi'ul mu'min its nights are long fa'tala laylahu and therefore he stands for prayer during them faqama and his days are short waqasara naharuhu fasama so he fast during the days. So this is a season where it's easy to do qiyam al-layl or tahajjud, and it's easy to fast. It's easy to do qiyam al-layl because the nights are very long. So the person can either stay up after Isha and pray and still get a healthy portion of sleep, or the person can sleep after Isha and wake up in the middle of the night and pray and still have time to return to sleep, or the person can get up well before Fajr after getting a good amount of sleep and pray and still have energy and vigor as they go through their daily activities because they've gotten an ample portion of sleep owing to the length of the night. طال ليله فقام And the days it's easy to fast because the days are very short during November and December and January. The days are very short and they're very cool. They're not hot. And so it's easy to fast. So now the person will be fasting or in a couple weeks from 6 in the morning until 4:30 at night in very cool days. So it's not challenging and straining for the believer. So this is a special time. And one of the reasons that he mentioned sallallahu, or one explanation we can give, we can't say the reason, that would be erroneous. One way we could explain his making this parable between the time we can pray and the time we can fast extra and the springtime. الشِّتَاءُ رَبِيعُ الْمُؤْمِنِ. The winter is the springtime of the believer. In the springtime, there is much vegetation. And so the animals, they get fat in the springtime. They fatten up. The grass is fresh. They're not eating dried grass. They're eating fresh grass. And the grass is very long. It's not eaten over and burned out like it is in the summer months. As we see here, the hills are green in the springtime. The grass is very tall. So the animals, and those of you from agrarian societies, in your villages back home, you know this very well. That's the best milk, because it's fresh grass, and it's available in abundance, and there's a lot of moisture in it. And the water is also abundant. So the animals get fat. The cows, their udders get very full with milk during the springtime, and the milk is very sweet. And so the Muslim fattens himself up, or fattens herself up. You know, sisters don't like to use those words in the same sentence. Metaphorically speaking, the believers fatten themselves up in the winter with the abundance of ajr and the abundance of thawab that he or she can earn from the lengthy nights that they're standing for prayer, that they will be challenged to stand for in the summertime when the nights are very short. And the short days where they're fasting more than they would fast in the summer voluntarily, because of the very long and very hot days which would challenge them to fast. So brothers and sisters, take advantage of this opportunity. We have another great blessing that Allah Ta'ala has given us with the entrance of the winter. So these two great virtues that are associated with the winter, الشِّتَاءُ رَبِيعُ الْمُؤْمِنِ طَالَ لَيْلُهُ فَقَامَ وَقَصُرَ نَهَارُهُ فَصَامَ. The fasting and the prayer, these are two great virtues that are also associated with the month of Al-Muharram, which we also are entering into, we've entered into. So the season that we enter into, the winter, coincides this year with the season we enter into Muharram. And so when Muharram is mentioned, these two great virtues are also associated with it. The Prophet ﷺ, in terms of the fasting, he mentions an Abi Hurairah radiallahu an. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أو سئل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أي الصيام أفضل بعد شهر رمضان فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم شهر الله الذي تدعونه المحرم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is related by Abi Huraira رضي الله عنه that a man came to him and he asked him, which fast is best after the obligatory fast of Ramadan? He said, fasting the month of Allah. Shahrullah alladhi tad'unuhu al-muharram, which you refer to as Muharram. So it said fasting, if any month fasting its entirety, the most virtuous of all months to fast in their entirety is the month of Al-Muharram. وَسُئِلَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَيُّ الصَّلَاةِ أَفْضَلُ بَعْدَ الْفَرِيضَةِ فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. And he was asked, صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is the same hadith, we broke it up. He was asked, which prayer is most virtuous after the obligatory prayer? He said, قِيَامِ اللَّيْلِ. قِيَامِ اللَّيْلِ. And there's specific hadith mentioning the virtue of Qiyam Layl in Muharram. So this is an opportunity for us, brothers and sisters, to get the virtue of fasting and praying also at a very special time, the month of Muharram. So we should avail ourselves of this opportunity. We should avail ourselves of the ease that Allah Ta'ala has facilitated for us to pray and to fast. Because this is the essence of what we're doing on this planet. Allah Ta'ala mentions in the Quran, oft-cited verse, where he says, Allahumma salli Rasulillah, wa ma khalaqtu al-jinn wal-insa illa liya'budun. I've only created the jinn and the human that they worship me. I've only created the jinn and the human that they worship me. And the two things that embody our worship and our devotion more than any other things, they are the prayer and the fasting. They're the prayer and the fasting. Other acts of worship, they're not relevant for everyone. So zakat, the pillars of Islam, naturally the shahada, we enter into Islam. But of our devotional acts, the prayer and the fast are general for everyone. And there are those who are exempted from fasting, but they're a very small minority. The prayer and the fasting are for everyone. The zakat is for those who possess an excess of wealth. And the hajj, similarly, those who have the wealth and the situation that allows them to go. So those are situational and circumstantial. But the prayer and the fasting is for everyone. And it's available for everyone. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encourages us to seek His help through two great means He's created to facilitate that, what does He say? وَاسْتَعِينُ بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْتَعِينُ بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. Seek the help of Allah literally with patience and prayer. But patience, as many of the exegetes remind us, الصَّبْرُ أي وَاسْتَعِينُ بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ أي بِالصِّيَامِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. So sabr here means with fasting and with prayer. As fasting is called, or patience is sometimes referred to as fasting. Because fasting involves patience. We have to refrain ourselves and we have to wait for the period to fast, to break our fast. We have to be patient with the pains that might come with fasting. The headaches or the nausea or stomach ache. We patiently deal with that difficulty. We have to refrain from that which is lawful for us, to say nothing of refraining from that which is unlawful, which we refrain from at all of our times. And so that involves restraining ourselves from that which is forbidden for us during the day of the fast. And those are the three aspects, basic aspects of patience. Patience has three basic aspects. As sabru ala ta'a, patience in dealing with the challenges that come in obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we're told not to use interest, engage in interest. That presents certain challenges for us. To refrain from alcohol, that presents challenges. Some people, if I put alcohol in my store, I can increase my profits exponentially. And if I increase my profits, I can have an easier life. No, we refrain from that and we deal with the hardship that might come from refraining from that. Just as we deal with the hardship, the headaches or nausea or stomach ache that comes in refraining from food and drink during the day of our fast. As long as it's not severe and would force us to break the fast or to be exempted from fasting. We wasabru anil ma'asiyah. So in being patient, in refraining from those things that constitute sin and rebellion against Allah. And so we refrain from those things that are sinful. As we just mentioned, selling alcohol, consuming alcohol is sinful, we refrain from it. And that might involve hardship as we mentioned. We're patient in obeying Allah. And wasabru عَلَى الْمُصِيبَاتِ, and patience in the face of calamity. So when we're tested with calamity, we don't lose our cool. We don't start blaming Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't engage in that which is forbidden because we see it as something that is we have a license for owing to the calamity that's befallen us. No, we're patient. We're patient. And we maintain our dignity. We don't lose our composure. We don't fall apart. We don't start acting and talking and behaving like people who don't have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their lives, who don't understand the reality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those aspects of patience are involved in fasting. There's musibah sometimes, which is the physical pain. There's refraining from that which is forbidden, which are the food and drink. And there's patience in persevering and obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, patiently enduring the fast as it moves through the length of the day, and patient in maintaining our dignity, not moping around and trying to show people we're fasting. They never know we're fasting. Just as they didn't know those Sahaba, they were poor because of their dignity. تَحْسَبُهُمْ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ. You would think they were well off and wealthy because of their refusal, because of their self-reliance and self-restraint. Fasting and praying, as we mentioned, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. These are symbols of our worship and symbols of our servitude. And this is what humanizes us. If Allah Ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, I've only created the jinn and humans that they worship me, then this is the rationale for our creation. We were created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to the extent that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we humanize ourselves. Because we're doing what human beings were meant to do on this planet. And to the extent that we abandon the worship of Allah, and we marginalize the worship of Allah, then we dehumanize ourselves. And we sink down to the level of the animals. Because why do we fast? Why do we fast, and what does it involve? We fast seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We fast to implement the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So it's been ordained for you. This is a commandment for us. This is why we fast. We fast voluntarily to draw ourselves near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرُّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهِ. My servant continues to draw close to me with the voluntary acts until I love him, until I love her. This is why we fast voluntarily. This is why we fast obligatorily. This is why we pray our obligatory prayers. This is why we get up in the middle of the night and we abandon our sleep and the comfort of our beds, and we go to the cold water and we make wudu and we pray, because we humanize ourselves and we maintain the legacy or the heritage of human excellence by so doing. And when we abandon the prayer, and we abandon the fast, and we abandon the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we dehumanize ourselves. And when we dehumanize ourselves, what is left for us except to sink to the level of the animals? Allah has created us to worship Him. As He mentions in a hadith Qudsi, يَبْنَ آدَمْ إِنِّي خَلَقْتُكَ الْعِبَادَةِ فَلَا تَلْعَبْ. O son of Adam, O child of Adam, verily I've created you for my worship, therefore don't play around. إِنِّي خَلَقْتُكَ الْعِبَادَةِ فَلَا تَلْعَبْ. And so when we abandon the worship of Allah, we sink down to the level of the animals, and we consume ourselves and lose ourselves in the emptiness of sport and play. All we do is play. نَلْعَبْ. And we're consumed with sport and play and we amuse ourselves to death, literally, to spiritual death, as opposed to bringing ourselves to life. Bringing ourselves to life. So brothers and sisters, take advantage of the opportunity to humanize yourself. Take advantage in what is the locus of our humanity? It is our hearts. It is our heart. أَلَا وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضَغَاتًا إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. Verily, in the body there is an organ. If it is sound, the entire body is sound. And if it is corrupt, the entire body is corrupt. Verily, it is the heart. So our prayer and our fasting purifies our hearts. And it renders our hearts. And some say the heart is synonymous with the ruin, this quality within us. One opinion, depending on the stage of its development, can be called qalb, or ruh, or nafs. But we're specifically mentioning the heart because of the textual reference. Ala wa hiya al-qalb. This morsel, this organ is the heart. As we purify it, it becomes more receptive to the divine messages and divine the compatibility and receptibility, its compatibility and receptibility with the divine message, it is enhanced. When our Prophet ﷺ mentioned, لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى يَكُونَ هَوَاهُ تَبِعًا لِمَا جِئْتُ بِهِ. So in a lower stage of development, this quality is called hawa. No one of you truly believes until their very inclination, the whims that emanate in their soul, are consistent with what I have brought. Hatta yufid al-taraqi, or thumma rather, but hatta ghaya, a goal that we move towards. And how do we move towards that goal? We move towards that goal with the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We move towards that goal with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is a manifestation of our worship. And a quality which must, for our worship to be meaningful, must be in all of our worship. وَاقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ لِذِكْرِي. Undertake the prayer for my remembrance. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. The prayer wards off indecency and lewdness, and the remembrance of Allah is greater. The Hajj. فَذْكُرُ اللَّهِ عِنَّ الْمَشْعِرِ الْحَرَامِ وَإِذَا فَطْتُمْ مِنْ عَرَفَاتِ فَذْكُرُ اللَّهِ عِنَّ الْمَشْعِرِ الْحَرَامِ فذكروه كما هداكم وإن كنتم من قبله لمن الضالين. So when you go down from Arafat, remember Allah at the Mash'ar al-Haram. Remember Him as He has guided you to. وإذا قضيتم مناسككم فذكروا الله كذكركم آباءكم أو أشد ذكرا. And when you finish the rites, then remember Allah as you remember your fathers, or even more intensely. So the Hajj, the fasting, the Salah, all of them should be embodied in the dhikr of Allah. And our tongue should be moist with the remembrance of Allah as we come and go throughout our day. Because this is what purifies our hearts. And this is what brings us into the realm of divine love. As Allah Ta'ala reminds us, Hadith Qudsi, which we partially quoted, but from the beginning of the Hadith, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربي عز وجل أنه قال من عاد لي وليا فقد أذنته بالحرب وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إليه إلي مما افترضته عليه
وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرُّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ وَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ فَكُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِي وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِي وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطِشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّهُ وَلَسْتَعَاذِنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّهُ.
And so, by taking advantage of these voluntary worship that draws even closer to Allah, what does Allah say? He draws himself or herself close to me until I love him, until I love her. And when I love him, I become the hearing he hears with, the seeing he sees with, the hand he grasps with, the feet that convey him. And were he to ask me of anything, I would give it. And were he to seek my protection, I will protect him or her. This is the realm, brothers and sisters, that we need to enter into. This is the realm of those individuals that impact their society. This is the realm of people when they speak, their words touch the hearts of people. You can hand out pamphlets all day and you can call that da'wah. That's not da'wah. You can beat other Muslims over the head until they follow your version of Islam. That's not da'wah. The da'wah is when the word that has become internalized in the depths of our soul emerges from our hearts through the translator of our tongue and sinks into the heart of another human being. That is da'wah. And that's what spread Islam to the far corners of the world. That is what created reality. When we look around this masjid, we see Muslims from all races and all ethnicities, from all socioeconomic classes, male and female. That universality is based on the universal nature of the heart and the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the impact, universal in terms of the impact they can potentially have on the hearts of any person, regardless of their age, their race, their gender, their ethnic, social, cultural, economic background. This is what we need, brothers and sisters. This is what we need. And when we do that, we won't have to engage in public relation campaigns to try to improve the image of Islam. That won't improve the image of Islam. The image of Islam will be improved when our hearts are improved. December, which we know every year, and when a proper Muslim questioned them, why are you fasting in December? We fast Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of the Muslim fast. Now they fast Ramadan. Walhamdulillah. May they continue to grow. But they said, we're a baby nation, so we have a baby fast. December is a baby fast for a baby nation. The shortest days of the year and some of the coolest days of the year. So they were a baby nation. So they had a baby fast. So it's easy for us to do the baby fast during these days that we're entering into. May Allah bless us to take advantage. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين يقول الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا ونبينا وشفيعنا ورسولنا وقرة أعيننا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا الحمد لله رب العالمين. To conclude, we'll make another reference to the heart. Allah Ta'ala mentions in the Quran, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَى قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وما نزل من الحق ولا يكونوا كالذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبل فطال عليهم الأمد فقست قلوبهم وكثير منهم فاسقون. Allah Ta'ala mentions, has the time not come for those who believe? أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, that their hearts become reverent and humble through the remembrance of Allah. أَنْ تَخْشَى قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, and what has been revealed of the truth. And they don't be like those who preceded them, and the time becomes long, the time between them and their prophet or the revelation, or for the convert, the time they converted, and then the time they're in now, relatively speaking. And their hearts become hard. فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. And many of them lose their moral bearings. This can happen to us, brothers and sisters. What is the cure? يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُحْيِي الْعَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. Allah mentions at the beginning of the next verse, you should know that Allah revives the earth after His death. Allah revives the dead earth with the life-giving rain. All this dead earth around us, in a couple of months, or even less, in a month, insha'Allah ta'ala, it will be brought back to life. All this burnt out stubble on these hills will be lush and green in a couple months. Insha'Allah, if it's a normal winter, Allah will revive the physical earth with the rain, and Allah revives the hearts with His remembrance. And تَخْشَى خُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهِ يُحْلَى الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. So when the hearts have become hard and dried and burnt over, like this earth around us, sprinkle the remembrance of Allah on that earth, brothers and sisters, and watch it bring forth its vegetation. But its vegetation isn't grass that you can eat, but it's good character that will benefit people just as the grass benefits the grazing animals. It's truthfulness on the tongue. It's sincerity in the intention. It's fidelity and faithfulness in the covenants and oaths. That's what the revived heart will bring forth. May Allah bless us to irrigate our hearts, to saturate our hearts with His remembrance. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا افرغ علينا الصبر وثبت قدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا افرغ علينا الصبر وثبت أقدامنا وتوفنا مسلمين. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن, ونعوذ بك من العجز والكسل, ونعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل, ونعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وكفر الرجال. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك, ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا بها جنتك, ومن اليقين ما يهون علينا مصائب الدنيا, ومتعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا, واجعله الوارث منا, واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا, وانصرنا على من عدانا, ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا, ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا, ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا, ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا, ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين وعفو عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم من أراد خيرا لهذه الأمة المحمدية فوثقه إلى كل خير، ومن أراد شرا لها وللمسلمين فخذ أخذ عزيز مقتدر واجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم. اللهم عليك بأعداء الإسلام أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أقم الصلاة يرحمني يرحمكم الله.